dysphagia means trouble swallowing, and it happens quite commonly after stroke. Probably about 50% of people with stroke have trouble swallowing, and that's because the stroke affects the parts of the brain and the nerves and the muscles that control swallowing. And what that means is that not only do people have trouble eating and drinking, but food can go down into the lungs instead of the stomach. That's called aspiration, and that can lead to pneumonia and infection and death. So it's a serious problem. So swallowing assessments can be done by specialists, speech-language pathologists, using sophisticated techniques and x-ray testing, but the screening test doesn't require that. The screening test is a simple bedside test that can be done by a speech-language pathologist, but can also be done by a physician or a nurse. So for quite a few years, there have been clinical practice guidelines in place, both in Canada and internationally, recommending that all patients with stroke have a swallowing screen done before the first intake of food. But we haven't known whether or not those guidelines have been followed and whether people truly have been undergoing screening. The other thing that isn't really known is, should people have a swallowing screen and should they fail that screen and have evidence of trouble swallowing, what is their prognosis? What happens to them? What is the true risk of pneumonia? Is that different across the board and in different subgroups of patients? And so we did the study to address those gaps in knowledge. We did the study using data from the Ontario Stroke Registry, which is a database of all patients with stroke from stroke centres across the province of Ontario. And we looked at patients over a 3-year period from 2010 to 2013, and we looked at how often patients received swallowing screening and whether or not they passed or failed. And then we linked that database to other databases held at the Institute for Clinical Evaluative Sciences, and we looked at the risk of outcomes over time, including things like pneumonia and death. We looked at over 7,000 patients, and we found that, surprisingly, almost 20%, or 1 in 5 patients with stroke, did not receive screening for swallowing problems. And in patients who failed the swallowing screen, they had much worse outcomes than people who passed screens. They were much more likely to develop pneumonia and much more likely to die within 1 year of stroke. We also looked at what the characteristics were of patients who were less likely to receive screening, and we found that people with mild strokes were about half as likely as people with other types of strokes to have a swallowing screen done on admission. And if people with mild strokes did receive screening, they were at substantial risk of failing that screening. About 30% failed the screen, and those people were at high risk of bad outcomes like aspiration, pneumonia, and even death. So we think that that's a population of patients who would really benefit from targeted quality improvement interventions to increase the rate of screening. We think that it's really important that people recognize that all patients with stroke should have a swallowing screen done when they're hospitalized, and that applies to patients with all types of strokes, from mild to severe. And there are clinical practice guidelines that exist to that effect. We hope that people will be aware of those guidelines and make sure that the screening is done in all patients. We also think that people should recognize that failing a swallowing screen is a poor prognostic indicator that is associated with the risk of bad outcomes, including death. And this might be something that should be incorporated into future risk prediction scores looking at outcomes after stroke.